Hey guys, so you may recognize this outfit from my haul video, but I did want to quickly just film another foundation review for you guys on a newish foundation on the market. It is the YSL Fusion Ink Foundation, which you guys know is crazy. I don't have the bottle, but I have a bunch of samples and I've been using it for a long time. And on Instagram, a lot of you guys wanted to hear my thoughts, but I personally wanted to compare it to and just really do a comparison to the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation, which is another foundation on the market, which is supposed to be very similar. And I thought that they would be exact dupes of each other. So if you guys want to know which one you should get over the other, if they're exact dupes, if I even like them, what I think about the YSL Fusion Foundation, then just stay tuned. Now my shade in the YSL foundations is BD50, and that is what I am wearing in the YSL Fusion Ink Foundation, which is also what is on my face today. In the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation, I take a 6.5. Now the YSL foundations come in a variety of undertones and a really big color range, which is fabulous. The Armani Maestro does come in a decent amount of colors, but the undertones are less varied in my opinion. It's a little bit more difficult to find your exact match, but with this foundation, it doesn't really matter as much because it does kind of adjust to your skin tone, and it is such a light foundation, the Armani, that you can be a little bit off and it will still work out perfectly for you. These do both have SPF in them. The YSL Fusion Foundation is SPF 18 and the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation is SPF 15. So, I mean, 3 points off if that really matters to you. These foundations are also both recommended for all skin types. However, I think they are better for normal skin, even to oily skin, not so much drier skin. In my experience, both foundations will cling to dry patches. It will just accentuate it and like pull those areas forward on your face and you'll see the flakes. I will say the YSL Fusion Foundation is a little bit more forgiving. The Armani is a little bit worse at showing up flakes, but I would say on the same kind of token, I would definitely say they are better for someone with normal skin. Oily skins would love it because it is a definite soft matte finish. The both of them give you a really nice matte finish. Like I said, I'm wearing it today. You can't see any shine on my face other than where I have personally added highlighter down the bridge of my nose and things like that on my cheekbones. Another reason they are the same, which is why you could be led to think they're dupes, is that they also don't let oils break through. With the both of these foundations, I can wear them all day. I don't really have to set them if I don't want to because they do dry to a kind of powdery finish, but they don't let oils break through. And if they do, it kind of breaks through in a way where it diffuses the skin. You never look like a reservoir of oil or anything like that. It just gives you kind of a soft glow to the foundation, maybe, if anything, but they are great at controlling oil, sweat, everything like that. They are true long wear foundations. If you want to get the max wear out of foundation, these two really just kind of set into the skin like ink, I guess, like the Fusion Ink would say. They are both very liquidy in texture. I would say the YSL Fusion Ink is a little bit more liquidy and a little bit more watery and runny, has more slip to it, although both are very liquidy. And they're both recommended to be applied with your fingers. However, I apply both with a brush and I still like it that way. I will say the texture of the YSL Fusion Ink is very different to any foundation I've ever used. Even with a brush, I can feel it feels very silky on the skin, which is strange. I mean, it's not a bad thing or a good thing, but it feels very like velvety and silky. You can literally feel like it just gliding on the skin, whereas with any other foundation, as you're buffing it in, it doesn't really feel like anything. So right now we have figured out that both foundations alone wear the skin type that they are best for. Both are great. I wanna talk about the main differences here, and that is, for me, the coverage. I think if you guys want an everyday foundation that is very light coverage, it's very off-duty, it just perfects your skin and takes out the redness, evens your skin tone out, and makes you look like you have great natural skin, I would go with the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation. This is the lighter coverage of the two. This is the only foundation that when I get really close up on the skin, all you can see, it looks like natural skin. I have fooled so many people when wearing this on an everyday basis that think I'm not wearing foundation because I don't know what it is about the Giorgio Armani Maestro, but they've just really cornered the market on making it literally look like natural skin. I would say YSL Fusion Ink is more of a foundation. And what I mean by that is the YSL Fusion Ink a little bit goes a long way, but you can definitely build it up to more of a medium to full coverage. You can get pretty flawless coverage with it. And it does look natural on the skin, but it isn't undetectable. It still looks like a foundation, if you guys know what I mean. If you guys wear makeup, you'll know what I mean. And it is the type of foundation that I could still do my heavy glam with. Like today, I've got my under eye concealer and things like that. It doesn't look out of place because it's really perfecting to the skin. So basically, I would say YSL Fusion Ink is like a more full coverage, more perfecting, more foundation version of the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation. The Maestro is even more kind of like a skincare. Think of it more along the lines of something as a BB cream. Really light coverage every day. Whereas YSL Fusion Ink Foundation, I would wear it out at night. I think it really comes down to personal preference. Do you guys want something really light coverage and everyday, or do you want something that can be worn as a night foundation, a day foundation that you want to do that has a little bit more coverage? That is up for you to decide, but I do think both are fabulous foundations. I'm very much impressed with the YSL foundation. I didn't think it was gonna be as good as it was. Didn't think I was gonna love it like I did, but I'm definitely gonna pick it up in the VIB sale. So I hope this has given you guys some food for thought. Foundation is something I love. Whoever invented foundation, thank you very much, because I think when you invest in a good foundation and your base is looking on point, you don't even need to do the whole shebang of eye makeup and stuff like that, but good skin and good foundation is the base for any makeup look, in my opinion. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you guys in the next one. Bye.